My dear friends, now we reflect on the fourth Lent readings. The first reading is from the book of 1 Samuel chapter 16. God is telling the prophet Samuel, how long will you cry over King Saul, whom I anointed as the king? But he, instead of honoring me and living according to the call of him, after the anointing, he became a different man. He did not bother to honor me. He lives for himself. So I am upset with him. God chooses people, and he wants to do things through them. He wants to bring God's power and God's work on this earth. But when we don't do it, well, though he never takes away the call from us, but in order to accomplish his mission, God looks for another people. If I go around, play with my life, and not bother about my call, God will not wait for me. God will choose somebody else and complete the work of God. So God tells Samuel, you don't cry over Saul. Now I have chosen another man. Take the horn of oil. Go and anoint one of the sons of Jesse, whom I have chosen. Jesse had 7 sons, and he brought all the 6 sons. He didn't bring the last one because he is small. Man always looks what is best for him. King means, anointed means, someone big, someone intelligent, and so on. But God doesn't look in that way. When the first sons of Jesse was brought and showed to Samuel, Samuel saw that man, very tall, handsome, well-built, and Samuel, though he was a prophet, he himself thought, this is the man God has chosen. But God said, no. He gives us a beautiful message in 1 Samuel 16:7. Man looks outside, but God looks at the heart. In the outside world, to do the work, or maybe even to do the war, a well-built man, very intelligent man, maybe the world may be looking for. But for God, he looks for people who hunger for him, who depend on him in all the times, who obeys God's will and brings God's glory through their lives. When Jesse brought 6 sons to be ordained, God rejected all the 6. So Samuel is asking, is there anybody else? And the father says, there is one guy, but he's a small fellow. And he is in the field. The father did not recognize him because he was small. But God recognized him because he knew the heart of David. David was not sitting. He was in the field doing his job. God looks for people who are on the job. They may be small. God looks for people who always hunger for him, who always delight in the Lord. Because David, as a little boy onwards, he had a special devotion to God of Israel. Through lute and harp, he used to sing songs to God. And God saw his heart, and he chose him. My dear friends, in the gospel also we find a blind man was being brought, and everybody thought he is blind, he is useless. And the Pharisees, who knew the word of God, the law of the Lord, they said, this man is blind because he's a cursed one. The way the world looks at is different from the way God looks at. God looks at people who are always ready to stand for God. And this blind man, they brought to Jesus and asked, why did this man become blind? Is it because of the curse of his life or the curse of his parents or foreparents? Jesus said, a person is blind not because of any curses. When you meet blindness, when you meet sickness, when you meet problems in the world, you should know that you have a God with you, and God allows this incident or people or events in your life in order to bring forth the glory and power of God. Every darkness, every dark night gives an opportunity to us to brighten the darkness with the light. So darkness never disturbs us. As long as we are conscious of the light in us and the mission we have received from God in the world is to brighten this dark world, to heal the sick world, to bring a blessing to this cursed world, God has chosen you and me. That's why in the gospel Jesus says, hello my dear, as long as I am here, I am the light of the world, he says. We all possess Christ Jesus. And so we can also tell along with Jesus, as long as we are in the light. And Jesus says, the time is coming. The dark hour is coming. So you have to better keep alive with the light to face the dark elements of your life. So Jesus, in the beginning of the gospel, he tells two things. This man is blind. Don't call it a curse. Every problem God allows in your life is to bring life out of the problem, to bring glory of God out of that bad situation. Yes. And God brought glory through this man. At the end of the story, we read that how this blind man brought glory to God more than any Pharisees who knew the scripture well. When the blind man was brought, Jesus healed that man. And he said, my son, I love you. Your blindness, the world may call it that you are blind, useless, you are accursed. But you are so precious to me. He spits. That is something part of him. The spittle is very precious for a man, for a digest, and which is part of man, which has healing power. And Jesus used his spittle and mix it with the clay and applies it on his eyes, tells him, I am sending you. God is sending you to the lake. And when he went to the lake, which is called a scent, he washed it and he got the sight. Everybody began to praise God, but not the Pharisees and Sadducees, who are the learned people. They asked this blind man, how did he become well? He said, the person called Jesus, he saw me, I am blind, but he realized that I can also become well. So he applied clay on my eyes, told me to go to the lake and wash. He sent me and I washed myself and I am well. They could not believe it. When you grow in the Lord, many, many obstacles will come. But remember, in spite of so many people, God has chosen you and me. We have to stand for God. Let anything happen. He has trusted us. We should be witness for him. And that's what the blind man did. Many obstacles came on his way. The Pharisees, they asked, how did he get healed? He was going on explaining to them the same thing. Jesus came and he told me to go and wash. He applied the mud on my eyes. I am born blind and I washed and I am got healed. Now I can see. They are not willing to believe. They called his parents. How did your son get blind? And was he blind from birth? And how did he receive the healing? Those parents, instead of praising God, my son is being healed by Jesus, we will stand for Jesus. No. They were frightened of the Pharisees. And so they act very, very politically. They say, diplomatically, they say, it's true he is our son. It's true he was born blind. But how did he get healing? We do not know. He is in age. He has grown up. Ask him. He will give the answer. They tried to escape. They didn't want to fall into the trick of the enemies. Yes. But not the blind man. The blind man said, he is the prophet. Yes, others are saying, what you are saying about this Jesus? Yes, when you have the light, stand with the light. Because the dark hour is coming. Unless you keep up your light today, tomorrow you can't face life. When I was a young boy, when I was studying, my prefect, the priest, he used to tell me, you do not know much Hindi, you are coming from Madras. So, you invest extra time. So, not only the present subjects, the next subject also you try to study. And it will be helpful to you. So, I used to study the Hindi subjects. Not only the subject that was taught to me, but I used to go with my own God-given wisdom and knowledge. The next syllabus, the next lessons. And when I go to the class, it was very easy for me. And at the end of the class, end of the session, I got first class in Hindi. Because God taught me to prepare ahead. We do not know what are the problems going to come in our life. So now itself, when we have the opportunity, we have to grow in the Lord. That's why in today's second reading from the book of Ephesians chapter 5, the Lord is telling us, you who is sleeping, awake, put on the power of Christ. That's why 5:10 says, blessed is the man whose strength is the Lord. Yes, we are in the world. God looks people who are hungering for him, who are burning with his light, and he will use us mightily. The world is looking for people like David. Though small, praising and thanking God, and he was anointed, and he destroyed Goliath, he destroyed Philistines, he became the king of Israel for 40 years. My dear, your life is not meant just to live and die. Maybe many problems are coming on your way. Didn't problem come on in the life of David or on the blind man? But both of them stood for God and they witnessed for God and God used them mightily. May our lives bring glory to God. At the same time, remember the dark hour is coming. Don't wait for the last hour to build you up. Now itself, grow in the Lord. There are so many evil will be coming on your way. There are so many evil habits will come on your way to try to take you away from it. That's why in today's second reading, Ephesians 5:11, St. Paul says, cut them away from your life. Throw it away from your life. If you are going to entertain with all kinds of evil that is coming behind you, you will be made to zero by the enemy. The enemy will come, Disturbance will come. Temptation will come. You have to be alert. Alert to stand with God, to shine in the light of Christ. And you will overcome the darkness. My dear, this is a precious time for you. In this season of Lent, let's prepare our hearts, the hearts that please through the Lord, the heart that is hungering for God as that of David, and to be witness to God like that of the blind man. And whatever the darkness comes, let me not get upset, but with the light in us, let's overcome the darkness and shine in the light of Christ. May Jesus bless all of you. Amen.